मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, इक्वेशन ऑफ अ लाइन इन अ स्पेस. इन दिस केस फर्स्टली आई डिस्कस द केस इन विच इट पासेस थ्रू अ गिवन पॉइंट एंड हैज गिवन डायरेक्शन. बेटा आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू टेल यू वन थिंग, यू हैव ऑलरेडी डन कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री. इन दैट केस वॉट यू हैव डन, इन दैट केस यू हैव डन दिस थिंग. वन पॉइंट फॉर्म क्या होती थी उस केस में? यू हैव राइटेड इट दिस वे, y माइनस 12 is equal to m into x minus x1. When you are dealing in this 1.1, same in 3D, when it is given to you this thing ki there is a line which passes through some point and has given direction, that means we are focusing on this one, a P line which passes through this point A, whose position vector is A. And let us take this point P on this line which are having a position vector R in this case. And it is given to you that this line is parallel to this vector B, whose position vector, the direction is given to you B. That means obviously when we have already done in class it 12 vectors, that when two vectors are parallel then they are scalar multiple of other. हमने किया था ना, we have discussed that thing, ki when one of them is scalar multiple of other, so that means ye vector kitna ho gaya lambda b. If it is parallel to this, so this vector having a position vector b, to ye kaun sa ho gaya? This one. And as you know by triangle law of covector addition, according to that op is equal to ap plus O. This is the case. You know this thing, vector law of triangle. Triangle law of vector addition kya tha? Ki this plus this is equal to OP. So we are using that one. Okay. And after that, what is this? This is lambda B and this is OP. Okay. And this one is R. So according to that, R is equal to A plus lambda B is the vector equation of a line where it passes through given point and has given direction, direction given है और point given है आपके पास. तो उस केस में आपके पास क्या हो जाएगा बेटा? इसमें R is equal to A plus lambda B. B क्या है? जिसके parallel होगा. और A क्या है? A कौन सा position vector है जिसमें से वो pass करता है. Okay? This is the vector equation. If you want to convert it into Cartesian equation, so Cartesian equation क्या होगी? Firstly, what you can do, R vector को लिख दो. एक्स आई कैप प्लस वाई जे कैप प्लस जेड जे कैप. ओके. एंड ए वेक्टर इज इक्वल टू एक्स वन, एक्स वन आई कैप, वाई टू वाई वन जे कैप एंड जेड वन के कैप. एंड बी वेक्टर, लेट अस टेक दिस एज ए आई कैप, यू कैन टेक इट इन दिस वे, कैपिटल ए वेक्टर, then ai cap plus bj cap plus c k cap. okay, now what you can do here beta, aap kya karoge is case mein? Isko likho, yahan put kar do xi cap plus yj cap plus zk cap is equal to x1 i cap plus y1 j cap plus z1 k cap. aur isko likho, ye aapke paas aa gaya ai cap प्लस वाई जे सॉरी बी जे कैप सी के. ओके, नाउ यू टेक इट ऑन दिस साइड, एक्स माइनस एक्स वन आई कैप, वाई माइनस वाई वन जे कैप, जेड माइनस जेड वन के कैप इज इक्वल टू ए आई कैप प्लस बी जे कैप प्लस सी के कैप. तो अब इससे देखो आपके पास क्या इक्वेशन हो जाएगी, x minus x1 upon a is equal to y minus y1 upon c and z minus z1 upon, sorry, b, and this is c in that case. Okay, this is the case. So this is the Cartesian equation of a line. Okay, passes through given point. So you can say when somebody asks you first one point form of a equation, so you can say R is equal to A plus lambda B. Now next is equation of a line passing through two given points. But what you have done in class 11, when two points are given to you, if somebody asks you, find out the equation of line. So, you can find out the y minus y1, 2 point formula to be y2 minus y1, x2 minus x1, up into x minus x1. Same in case of 2D, when two points are given to you, and it is given to you that this line is passing through these two points. Okay, we have taken this thing and we said, कि दिस लाइन AB इज पासिंग थ्रू पॉइंट A हुज कोऑर्डिनेट इज x1 y1 z1 एंड B हुज कोऑर्डिनेट इज x2 y2 z2 देन वी हैव टेकन इन वेक्टर फॉर्म के पोजीशन वेक्टर ऑफ दिस इज A वेक्टर एंड पोजीशन वेक्टर ऑफ दिस इज B वेक्टर ओके एंड दिस इज गिवन टू यू पोजीशन वेक्टर ऑफ P इज गिवन टू यू R नाउ व्हाट यू कैन डू इन दिस थिंग फर्स्टली You can draw this figure and find out the things. Keep this. When you get this triangle OAP, according to that rule, this is the case. This plus this is equal to this. Or you can say that this minus this is equal to this. Okay. AP. From here we can say that AP is equal to OP minus OA. So you can write it here. AP is equal to OP minus OP. So OP is R and A OA is A. So OAP is equal to R minus A vector. Similarly, when you take this triangle OAB, when you take this triangle OAB, according to that, you can say this thing, this OB is equal to OA plus AB. Okay, so AB, you can say this is B minus A. And you can see this vector is B minus A and this is R. And these are collinear because there is a common point A in that. From here, when two vectors are collinear, then one can be expressed as a scalar multiple of other. So you can say if these are collinear, if R minus A is equal to lambda B minus A. Just like in parallel, it is collinear. So from here, we got this. So this is the vector equation of a line when passing through two given points. और बेटे अब इसको कार्टेशियन फॉर्म में चेंज करना है तो कार्टेशियन इक्वेशन क्या होगी r वेक्टर इज इक्वल टू xi प्लस yj प्लस zk a वेक्टर को पुट कर दो x1 i कैप प्लस y1 j कैप प्लस z1 k कैप एंड b वेक्टर इज इक्वल टू x2 i कैप प्लस y2 j कैप प्लस z2 k कैप नाउ यू कैन पुट इट इन दिस इक्वेशन xi yj zk एंड हियर x1 i कैप प्लस y1 j कैप प्लस z1 k कैप And when you take b minus a, it is obviously x2 minus x1 I cap, y2 minus y1 j cap, and z2 minus z1 k cap. When you compare the coefficients, you will get x minus x1 upon x2 minus x1, y minus y1 upon y2 minus y1, and z minus z1 upon z2 minus z1 is equal to lambda. From here, this is the Cartesian equation of a line, and this is the vector equation of a line. Okay, clear? Now, we can start exercise 11.2, first question. First question is, show that the three lines with direction ratios cosines this 12 by 13 minus 3 by 13 and 4 by minus 4 by 13. And second line, these are 4 by 13, 12 by 13 and 3 by 13. Next is given to you 3 by 13 minus 4 by 13 and 12 by 13 are mutually perpendicular. But ये क्या हो गया आपका? इसको हम क्या करोगे? आ गया L1, M1, M1. This is L2, M2, M2. And this is L3, M3, L3. Okay? So now when you want to prove this thing, कि these are mutually perpendicular, what you can do? You can prove this thing L1, L2 plus M1, M2 plus M2, N1, N2 is equal to 0. And L2, L3 plus M2, M3 plus N2, M3 is equal to 0. And L3, L1 plus M3, M1 plus N3, N1 1 is equal to 0. If you can prove these conditions from here, you can say this thing, ki these are mutually perpendicular. Now you can prove it. Put it here the values, 12 by 13. Then L2 is 4 by 13. Plus M1 minus 3 by 13. Then M2 12 by 13. Next is minus 4 by 13. And here it is 3 by 13. You want to put this thing, these are 0. So 48 minus 36 minus 12 upon 169. You got this result 0. Similarly, you can prove other parts. When you can prove all these, then you can say they are mutually perpendicular. Not only proving by single part, you can say these are mutually perpendicular. From here, it is only clear this, that this and this line is perpendicular. Mutually perpendicular means L1, L2 ke saath bhi, L1, L3 ke saath bhi. Same L2, L3 ke saath bhi aur dusra. Is it okay? Clear? I hope this is clear to you. Next one is question number 2. Question number 2 is, show that the line having DR, line D is point given as 1, minus 1, 2 and 3, 4, minus 2. Firstly, you find the DRs of this. DRs kaise find out karte? 3 minus 1, 2. 3 minus 1 is 2. 4 plus 1, 5. Minus 2, minus 2, minus 4. Ye aage DRs. Iske AB. DRs of AB. If this is A and this is B. Now you can find the DRs of CD. Next point aapko given is 0, 3, 2 and 3, 5, 6. 0, 3, 2. 0, 3, 2 and 3. 3 minus 0 is 3. 5 minus 3 is 2. And 6 minus 2 is 4 in this case. Okay. These are the DRs. Now what do we want to prove? Ki they are mutually perpendicular. Now again you can prove this thing. A1, A2 plus B1, B2 plus C1, C2 is equal to 0. So 6 plus 10 minus 16 is equal to 0 in this case. Okay? And if you want to prove it, it is parallel. So, beta, parallel mein pata kya condition le lena? Ye book karo. A1 upon A2, B1 upon B2 is equal to C1 upon C2. This is the condition of parallelism. Okay? I hope you are able to solve the question number 3 with the help of this. Okay. Now we will move to the next one. Question number 4. Okay. Now firstly you can note down this one.